So here we go then. It's a very good morning from me, Johnny Bryan, and I welcome you to Twickenham for the 2016 NatWest Schools Cup Finals Day. This is one of the great days of schools rugby, where eight of the finest rugby schools in the land will battle it out for the four prizes that are on offer this afternoon. It's a cool, fresh morning here at Twickenham, but soon it will become a cauldron of action and be a hot furnace indeed. The first match of four we'll have for you is between Dr. Challoners Grammar School against Sir Thomas Rich's School for the under 15 Vase final. So this is how the two teams will line up. First of all, for Dr. Challoners Grammar School, the forwards are number one, Sid Day, two, Jake Wilkins, three, Ben Quick, four, Dom Goodman, five, Joe Long, six, Ed Griffiths, he is the captain, seven, Daniel Peters, eight, James Tunney, nine, the scrum half is Devon Owen, 10, Monty Weatherall, the fly half, Blake Morris as number 11, the centres, Richard Dean and Zach Gillingborn, Ollie Anderson, 14, the fullback, Huey Chadwick, and they are coached by Mr. Chris Duggan. Sir Thomas Rich's School, number one, Guy Floyd, number two, Cameron Wilkinson, three, James Emerson, four, Miles Wilson, five, William Sanderson, he makes up the second row, along with Oliver Edginton, Joe Hocking, Liam Richards, the 6, 7, 8 respectively, the scrum half Oliver Gordon, fly half Daniel Walker, Luke Pardo on the wing, the centres Matthew Lampett and Ben Gleeson, who's their captain, Seth Price on the other wing, Andrew Hunter is the fullback, and Rhys Morgan Davis is their coach. The replacements for each team: Valji Race, Spenewin, King, Bellamy, Hodson and Barraclough for Dr. Challoners, and for all, Sir Thomas Riches, Bagnall, Daniels, Holmes, Raffi, Mosley, Brearley and Ethan Yip. So these were their roads to Twickenham. Dr. Challoners first, with victories over Palmerston School, the Windsor Boys School, Reading School as well. Desborough College, a 50-0 win there. Daunceys, 31-0. Clifton, 32-0. Really putting a few teams to the sword en route to this final. The Manchester Grammar School by 28 points to 10. And then the semi-final defeating Bridgewater by 41 points to 12. Passes out for Sir Thomas Riches, going out in the cup against Cheltenham Bourneside, and then in the Vase, an away draw against Cleve School. Chosen Hill School, 17 points to 10. Church down by 48 points to nil. Then victories over Woodlands Academy and Trent College. Then an away win at Chislehurst and Sidcup Grammar School before that semi-final victory against Bishop Vases Grammar School by 23 points to 19. The gentleman to my right has been as sipped from the cup of greatness at Twickenham on a number of occasions as a coach. The former Dulwich coach, Sam Howard, is alongside me. Sam, a very good morning to you. This makes a change, as it were, because it's you're up here with me instead of looking after the team as you have done the last few years.
Yes, good morning. It's actually nice to have a relaxed feel about today and not have a load of pressure preparing a team. So I'm really looking forward to all four games. I'm sure we're in for an absolute treat with all four of them. The semi-finals were fantastic, so hopefully we've got four cracking games of rugby coming up.
Just tell me what goes through a coach's mind ahead of these finals. You've been in four of them, winning on three occasions. So how do you prepare the teams for such a big occasion like this?
You've got to try and treat it just like any other game, and that's the difficult part. Especially as a coach, you feel the pressure, you feel excited. Obviously, you don't get the chance to play or coach at Twickenham very often. But you've got to try and keep the boys grounded, keep them calm, train just as normal, do as much preparation as you can, but try and get the boys to enjoy the occasion as much as possible rather than get overwhelmed by it. And it's normally the team that plays to their normal style, keeps relaxed, is the one that normally comes out on top.
it's a lot of, especially for the kids at this level, a lot of nervous excitement. You know, they're really excited to get on the pitch, but when they see the big hallowed turf and all the green seats around them, knowing they're playing on the hallowed turf, as it were, you know, they must feel a bit of butterflies as well as excitement.
Oh, they absolutely love it. And fair play to the RFU in Twickenham. You come on the Tuesday beforehand, so you get used to it, and you have a little look around. So you try and prepare yourselves, and the boys are obviously very excited, especially with the sort of Six Nations going on at the moment. So they're seeing the England players play at Twickenham, and now they've got their chance to go out onto the hallowed turf. Every boy's dream to play at Twickenham. So yeah, they're understandably excited, and you want that. You want the boys to be excited, and hopefully they use that excitement in a positive way when they're out there playing.
So we're just moments away from the opening tie of four on this cool day here in Twickenham. Me and Sam were reminiscing now as we were coming to the commentary box this morning about some of the fine weather we've had in the past. And then Sam reminded me of a final about 2 or 3 years ago when it was -2 and it was snowing. And that one slipped my mind, in all fairness. But today's conditions, Sam, reasonably good. But there's an easterly wind that might annoy the kickers. But apart from that, good conditions.
Yeah, it's dry, which is what you want, basically, when you're playing. There's a little bit of breeze out there. But look at that surface. You couldn't ask for anything more. So these boys are going to go out there and hopefully have a real good crack, play positive rugby and thoroughly enjoy their day out at Twickenham, which is what it's all about.
Absolutely, the two teams just coming on their way out now. Dr. Challoners Grammar School from, they haven't travelled that far, only from Amersham in Buckinghamshire. It's a little bit different for me this year. I usually commentate on the far side of the field, but I'm right above the crowd this year. So that roar was a good one as well for the Dr. Challoners School. As I said, they haven't travelled too far, only from Buckinghamshire. So Thomas Richards, close ties to Gloucester as well. So it should be a very much an entertaining first tie, this one. Dr. Challoners School, all in red. Sir Thomas Richards in the hoops. They're the ones in your screen right now. And both their captains now just giving them their final instructions before the battle commences. What's the last thing you've said to all your guys before they go out? To just keep the concentration, keep their focus, try and get on the... get the ball rolling early, just build momentum in that first quarter of the game especially.
Yeah, again, we tried to do exactly what we were doing before any normal Saturday game, and we do our warm-up, and the last thing I say to the guys is out on the warm-up pitch, and then they go into the changing room, and then it's all down to the captain for the last 5, 6, 7 minutes. It's down to the players out there. So my last words are always just come out firing. It's pretty simple. Everyone's different, but the boys out there, you can always sense the excitement of some of those kids that are running around, they're clapping, they're cheering. Like, this is what it's all about. Boys' dream to play at Twickenham. Hopefully they can do them all themselves justice out there.
Andy Taylorson is our man in the middle, as the first final of four is underway here at Twickenham. Dr. Challoners School in red, going from right to left on your screen. So Thomas Richards from left to right. Oliver Gordon, scrum half. Little chip forward there from Daniel Walker. Finds a little bit of space on the wing. And they've started their stall out early here. So Thomas Richards attacking from the front foot with Ben Gleeson, the captain. Picked up by Miles Wilson. Takes two or three lads to get him down and gains a couple of yards. A little box kick up in the air to test the fullback. And that's a test that he hasn't passed in the first opening minute of the game. So they're not an advantage to come here for Sir Thomas Richards, who may be sensing something even more, but got out into touch. And a good start from the school from Gloucestershire.
Great start from Sir Thomas Richards. Good claim from the kickoff, which is always what you want, to calm those early nerves. Lovely little chip from the fly half, then a good kick from the scrum half, obviously looking to play a bit of territory. So perfect start from Sir Thomas Richards. Now they've got that territory and they can build some pressure now.
First test for Jake Wilkins, the hooker, and that's not one he has passed with flying colours as well. Also Thomas Richards in this opening period of the game. Gordon into the Dr. Chandler's 22. Gordon goes to his left. Picked up by Will Sanderson.
Move.
Gordon. Good defence there from Dr. Challoners, sending him back from whence he came.
No hands, there you go.
Another chip forward. And again, it's a something that they have struggled with a little here, as Dr. Challoners at the start.
It'll not come back.
But they will have the put in the scrum. What are the chance to clear their lines? Testing the fullbacks is the young scrum half, Oliver Gordon, with a couple of chips to the chips, and it's, guys, it seems to work for them in this opening couple of minutes. Okay.
Yeah, I wonder whether that's a pre-game ploy to put lots of little chips in. Maybe in their 22 you want to keep the ball in hand, because they've looked good with the ball in hand. They haven't given it away. But again, they're still in the 22. They're going to probably end up with a line out, but unfortunately under 15s, the line out's a bit of a lottery, as you can't lift, so you can't really blame the boys if they lose a line out, because it's pretty tough to get your own ball.
indeed it is. Picked up by Owen. Ollie Sanderson going to ground.
Stay back. Hold.
Owen. Kick downfield. And a good one it was from Huey Chadwick. And the Dr. Challoners crowd, who are quite vocal in this opening a couple of minutes below us, they've brought a good crowd with them here to Twickenham. And now a chance for the Buckinghamshire School to get on the front foot. Weatherall. A little bit of a juggling act there from Richard Dean. But a good offload it was, and now they're off and running. Just up to halfway.
Advantage!
Owen, with an advantage to be played here. I think it might only be a knock-on advantage, though. And Owen finds a little bit of space. Needs a little bit of help and gets it from Daniel Peters. Owen. Weatherall.
Second up and 10.
Crossfield kick, high into the air. That's a good test and an excellent take it was from Luke Pardo. But they're going to come back for an early infringement.
You got a number, Steve.
Superb play by Dr. Challoners there. They've kept the ball for 4, 5, 6 phases. Both teams are actually keeping the ball really well. Like to actually see them keep the ball in hand. Neither of them have looked like turning the ball over when they've had it in hand. So if they can keep it in hand, I think they can pose threats. Super break by Owen, the scrum half there, who looks lively. So both teams probably be fairly pleased with their start so far.
And the first attempted goal. Just to remind you, 13 minutes and a half here in these finals. Spotting just some of Fleet Street's finest are covered in this game as well. Yeah. Telegraph's Gareth A. Davis to our far left, up here in the commentary box.
By setting his own example, really.
But can Monty Weatherall ask? Puts the first bit of ink for all the journalists up here, and the opening score of this NatWest Schools Cup Finals day for 2016. Sends it on its way, but it's wide. So then, 5 minutes down, we still remain pointless.
10.
Just an example there, Sam, that there is a lot of wind 10. In here at Twickenham today, and it's not a wind that this ground is used to. It's an easterly wind, and it's going to be quite an adverse effect for the kicking today.
It's never easy for a young kicker. First game at Twickenham, first points of the game. Really tough on these young boys. You've got to remember that these kids are probably 14 or 15. So I don't think we can really have any go at any one that miskicks a goal. Like, he struck it nicely. He hit his kick well. So I dare say he'll have another go, and hopefully it goes over, because he struck the ball really nice and, as you say, just missed on the left-hand side.
Okay, try hard to stay on your feet. There's your mark.
As you can see, great crowd here we have this morning for this first game of four.
Just come up a bit closer to the mark, please. Just
come on. And always well attended these Schools Cup Finals down this, Sam. I know your crowd from Dulwich used to bring an army down. Warwick always used to bring a war with them. Always well represented all these schools.
Yeah, it's a great occasion for the whole school to come down to Twickenham and cheer on your fellow pupils and mates. And as you say, Dulwich, very easy as we were obviously in London, but used to bring absolutely thousands of, not just pupils, but old boys, parents, friends, really used to use the day as an occasion. And it's great to see so many supporters here supporting these boys.
And the referee has called that one back. Our referee, Andy Taylorson.
Gentlemen, it's important that we stay straight and square.
So okay. Reset and go again.
You can only push for a metre and a half. All right? Here's your mark. Crouch. Bind.
So Thomas Rich has made the Vase final. On my first ever time commentating this, 4 years ago in 2012. Lose now to Dauncey's by 17 points to 5. So a sweet revenge beating them on the way to this final. Okay. For Sir Thomas Riches.
Okay. All right, let's have the ball hooked back. Come up closer, thank you.
So another goal here at the scrum.
Crouch. Set. Bind. Set. Let's go quick.
Devon Owen with the put in. See how we go on this time.
Use it.
Owen collects. Now the running. There's a good little chance here for Dr. Challoners as well, out wide. They've created a little bit of space, and a good opportunity it is as well for number 11, Blake Morris. Gained some territory here. Owen.
Move, Tapper!
Weatherall. Oh, my word. That's the first big hit of the day. Okay. Owen. Weatherall. Collingbourne. Out wide and now picked up by Sir Thomas Rich's Luke Pardo.
No advantage.
The referee
coming.
Spotted the knock on, and
red.
It will be Sir Thomas Rich's with the button.
Real shame there, because that was great play by Dutch Channelers. They've moved the ball wide. Looks as if Monty Weatherall can pass the ball off either hand. They've spread. They've gone from side to side and created some space out wide. Just an unfortunate knock on there, but it's great to see Dr. Channelers throwing the ball around and really playing with some adventure out there.
Correct.
Dr. Channelers, their first Twickenham final.
Mind. Set.
In the many, many years that this great competition has been going. And right now, they're not fazed by a first Twickenham final. An excellent take that was as well from the fullback Huey Chadwick. And Chadwick is off to the races and a good juggling act. Good to gain possession and an excellent offload that was from Killingbourne. This is Blake Morris. Morris inside. Weatherall. Into the Easter Thomas Rich's 22, roared on by their faithful.
Penalty advantage.
Owen.
No hands, blue.
And they'll get the penalty. And they've gone quickly, but the referee wants them to come backwards. He didn't see the little tap and go. So back we go.
Fantastic play from the fullback Chadwick there, catching the ball on the full and having a go and using the width. And
they've gone quickly. Tunney. They're smelling blood here, 10 minutes into this half. Comes a little drive forward, just shy of the line. Little drive again.
No hands!
That's how far they are. How far out they are. Owen. Tunney.
Back foot on the line.
Owen. Weatherall. Ball
backwards.
Lost, but did it go backwards? It did. Still in red hands. Owen. Sid Day, Blake Morris, it's going to be the opening score for James Tunney. <laughs> 10 minutes in to this first half, James Tunney draws first blood of this Vase final. A very well worked try. Dr. Chandler's on the board, 5-0.
What a fantastic try. As you saw from the penalty, as we talked about earlier, there's no point going for lineouts because you can't lift. So they've taken the quick tap, they've recycled the ball, they've actually offloaded quite a few times in this first half. It's obviously a ploy of theirs. They're obviously coached really well to offload. Superb try and thoroughly deserved in this first half.
James Tunney with the opening score of the game. And now Weatherall looking to add the extras. It might slide in. It does slide in.
What a kick from the young man.
That was hit like a power fade with a driver off the tee. It just slid in through the post and Dr. Chandler's lead by 7 points to 0.
For a 14-year-old boy to be banging it over from the touchline is absolutely outstanding, and that will definitely increase his confidence for the rest of the game.
Daniel Walker will restart for Sir Thomas Riches. How do they respond? Picked up by Dom Goodman. Sent backwards by Guy Floyd. Walker. A little bit of a juggling act for the Sir Thomas Riches fullback there, but it's not a bad return. A little bit awkward there for Monty Weatherall. And sends it backwards, and they gain some territory from the line out, but it'll be just shy of the halfway line.
Pardon?
Talk us to this try then, Sam. It was very well worked, went through the phases, and what they deserve from this, from what they got.
Yeah, it all came from that counter-attack from when they countered from deep. They kept the ball well. Great offload there from the winger. Number six, as we talk about all the time, do your basics. You draw the man, give a good pass, the winger, and the number eight scores in the corner. Do the basics well, and you'll end up scoring tries.
Approaching the halfway point of this first half. Dr. Chandler's lead with that James Tunney try. To Thomas Riches. Really trying to test the lads at the back. Blake Morris there. But it's a good band. It was spotted by our referee, and it will be their rewards for those testing those Dr. Chandler's back. They've picked up a scrum and a little bit of afters here from these young lads. Obviously had plenty of energy this morning. They must have been up very early, Sam.
You all stay in the same hotel beforehand, and you don't envy the guys that are leaving at sort of 7 o'clock to come and play this game. But the good thing is, it's out of the way. You haven't got that nervous energy of hanging around. That's the toughest thing for sort of the latter games, is what you do with the boys for all the morning to try and keep them occupied. But hopefully, it'd be good to see Sir Thomas Riches try and keep the ball in hand, not kick the ball away as much.
And they may have a good opportunity here with Walker. And a good try for that is from Guy Floyd. Deep into the Dr. Chandler's 22 here. They're just shy of the 5 metre line. And they win a penalty for their endeavour.
Shot.
Yeah, good play from Sir Thomas Riches there. They kept the ball, didn't keep it away. And if you keep the ball for long enough, the opposition will invariably either give a penalty away or maybe there'll be a gap for you to exploit. So, again, they've kept the ball well there. Hopefully, they can get 3 points on the board here.
Yeah.
So then, Daniel Walker, can he cut the deficit here? Kick about 15 metres out. This to reduce the deficit to 4 points. Relatively straightforward. Nonchalantly put over by Daniel Walker. And now the score is Dr. Chandler 7. Sir Thomas Riches score 3.
Yeah, really confident strike from the young flyer half there. I'd say just his little 9-iron, chipped it over, never looked in doubt.
So then, 7-3. And a good take that was as well from Oliver Gordon.
Hands. There it is.
So Thomas Riches score. Looking to find a footing in this game now. Only 4 points down. Long way to go. Good 45 minutes or so of rugby to go. We've seen many great finals here at Twickenham over the last 4 years. And we've brought you. Owen, chip forward from Weatherall to test Andrew Hunter at the back. And a good return that was from Andrew Hunter. Under a little bit of pressure there. And he kicked well.
Great play from Hunter. He's right on his goal line and he's got the ball almost to the 10-metre line. And on this big pitch for these young boys, that's a superb kick. But again, you see Sir Thomas Rich's kicking the ball away. Dr. Challoner's got three guys, Sir Thomas Rich has got three guys back. Try and keep the ball in hand. I think on this wide pitch, it's so difficult to defend. If you can try and play with a little bit of adventure, I think they'll get the rewards.
Time off, Malcolm.
One of these Sir Thomas Rich's players just coming up to the touchline here. I think he might have just have a little niggle. Number 13, their captain, Ben Gleeson.
Hang on a minute.
And he's going to be replaced by number 20, okay. Will Mosley.
Okay, wait a minute. Time on, please.
So then, line out by Dr. Chalmers, and it is picked up by number 12, Richard Dean. Killingbourne looking for a bit of help. This is Dean. No help there with him though, but Dr. Chalmers in a danger area here.
Scrum advantage, knock on blue.
Griffiths, Weatherall, Chadwick. Pirouetted one way or the other, that ball has been knocked forward. And we go back for an earlier knock-on, and it will be Dr. Chandler's
knock
with the putting.
Trailing hand.
But you see the danger here, Sam, of how Dr. Chandler's can be on the counter-attack.
Oh, their backs look really dangerous. Superb little back play. Colin Bourne busts through the middle, then an offload to Dean. Really playing with good skill and adventure out in their backs. That's a lovely line. Love the fact they're always looking to offload, turning their head, trying to keep the ball alive as much as they possibly can. Great adventure from Dr. Challoners.
Don't normally wait for that. Now, come on.
Yeah, as you can see, there's plenty of endeavour in this side, and it could be very dangerous on the counter-attack, and so Thomas Richards will need to be wary of that. We've already had one reset scrum.
Gentlemen,
whilst that replay was taking place, that was the second,
square.
So we're going to have a third now.
Which way it's going.
The curse of all televised games, please. Reset scrums. Come on, ref, get it out.
You're going to sound like Brian Moore now all of a sudden.
Crouch. Bind. Set. Use it.
Owen picks up. the pass didn't work though too well that time. Ball knocked forward, and Sir Thomas Richards will have now the chance to clear their lines from inside their own 22.
Please, I must have you straight and square before the ball's presented.
This
all
is
right?
Still a real tough place to get out of for Sir Thomas Richards. Like on this wide pitch, scrum right in the middle. Like it's a long way to the touchline for these kids. So it'll be interesting to see whether they actually have a run or whether they're going to kick the ball and give the ball back to Dr. Challoners.
So let's see what the Gloucester score can do here. Little chip forward, a little sliced off the boot, but it seems to work though. Walker. And a few's made the trip down the M4 to be here with us. Thomas Richards will get the penalty. I'm just, I can see down to my right. There's a few from Sir Thomas Richards' school, but I think they are 3-1 against from Dr. Chalmers here. I think they haven't travelled too far, only from Amersham. So it's about what, half hour, 45 minutes away from here. So it's a good crowd for them today.
They've brought absolutely loads with them. Oh, now Dr. Chalmers could counter again here.
And this is where they have been dangerous in this first half. Seth Price.
Hold.
Gordon.
Player.
Kick is blocked. And maybe one or two knock-ons there. And the first infringement was from Sir Thomas Richards, and it will be red ball. Dr. Chandler's with the putting.
Pardon?
Oh, boys, it's ours.
Crouch.
20 minutes.
Bind.
Into this game. Just give you an idea as well. Our clock is just an indicator of where we are. We will go on the referee's whistle. And Tunney put into touch, and he wasn't too pleased there with
red here.
With that play.
There's your mark, red.
And a number of afters as well.
Just there.
My word.
Set for me, please, red. Step, step.
Cameron Wilkinson.
Not straight.
That one wasn't too straight. I'm going to have a scrum down red ball.
No. Good to see Sir Thomas Richards actually trying something. As I say, you can't lift it at this age group, so you may as well try and go shorten the line out and try something different. It's just a case of winning your own ball at this level, and they've tried to go with a four-man and tried a little clever one at the front there. Just didn't quite come off, but it's great to see that they're actually trying to do something and they're thinking of ways of winning the ball at line-outs.
A little bit of creativity is what we do like to see. Oh, it looks a bit high. And a little bit of afters as well.
Six, leave it!
Well, I think these lads must have been up very early this morning.
Off you go. Calm down, gentlemen, all right? Calm down. High tackle.
Well, the referee just telling the players just to calm down a little. Big occasion for both of these sets of teams, though. You can understand that both of them will want it.
Mine's yours, Blue.
Both of them hungry for victory.
There's your mark, red. How many?
An excellent kick it was there from Monty Weatherall. And Jake Wilkins now with the line out on the Sir Thomas Richards 22. Good tackle there on Devin Owen. Picked up by Daniel Peters, who gains a couple of yards. Jake Wilkins into the 22. Owen. Weatherall. Picked up by Richard Dean. Dean, good offload from Tunney. Tunney. Out towards Ed Griffiths, the captain. 5 metres short.
Back foot.
Owen. Weatherall. Picked up by Wilkins, 5 metres short. So Thomas Richards need to try and hold on here. Owen. Tunney. Using his strength, a la Jamie Roberts. Goodman. Good tackle. And they win the penalty. Good defence there from Sir Thomas Richards.
Great defence from Sir Thomas Richards. They're right on their line. Fair play, Dr. Challoners. Again, offloading the ball, running at pace, really looking a big threat in attack. But Sir Thomas Richards are on their line. They've held out and they've got the penalty, but they haven't found touch and they're going to come back at them.
They haven't found touch. A little bit of a juggling act there from the Dr. Challoners wing. This is Chadwick, who has been a danger on the counter attack. No, lovely little offload from Weatherall. This is Colin Ball.
What an outrageous piece of skill in under 15 final at Twickenham. Fair play, Mr. Weatherall. That's great to see.
Time off, Martin.
Cheeky, very, very cheeky.
Captain.
Oh, Leo. That'll be one to tell the grandchildren 60 years from now.
Mr. Captain. Chris, go back to the mark.
How many times is he going to watch that over the Easter holidays?
It's okay. I know that it's a final, so it's a vacation, but you're still...
Well, Weatherall definitely right. Showing the full Monty here at Twickenham. 5 minutes to go.
Back we go.
I think what's great to see is just to see how good schoolboy rugby this is. These are under 15 players. They're ball retention, they're offloading, they're tackling. Their lines are running. It's absolutely fantastic to see. These guys are also being coached really well. They're buying into it and they're playing with, as you say, good adventure. And it's a superb game so far. Really enjoying this.
Calm down, please. That's you, Blue.
So around about 5 minutes or so left to play. Wilkin. Tunney picks up.
Hold.
Owen. Weatherall. Lovely inside pass. Dr. Challoners really playing some good running rugby here. And playing with flair. Weatherall. Collingbourne. Chadwick. So Thomas Rich has been on the back foot here for much of the second half. And now the drive continuing to go into the 22. They come.
Use it once.
And still an excellent drive, and still will begin into work. Now uncontested, and it will be Sir Thomas Riches with the putting.
Again, Sir Thomas Riches really scrambling in defence very well. Dr. Channeler's back line looks really dangerous off their set plays. They've got some good moves, and they're nearly always breaking through. But Sir Thomas Riches is getting back, scrambling, and they've held them up there. It's great to see that they're never giving up, because Dr. Challoners are making breaks, they're busting through, but Sir Thomas Riches aren't letting them get over that try line cheaply.
Set!
We'll try that one again.
Here's your mark. You should hit the mark. What's going to happen? Set! Crouch! Set! Bind! Set! Use it.
So Thomas Rich is looking to clear, and I'm not a bad kick that one is too. Puts Chadwick under pressure, but he collects with aplomb. Owen. Tunney. Ollie Anderson. Dr. Chandler's school really on the front foot, and have been for much of this first half. And Sir Thomas Riches again, their defence holding strong, and they'll have the chance to clear once more.
Let's go, come on.
Sir Thomas Riches just needs some territory. I think the last 10-15 minutes has all been played in their own half. They're kicking the ball, but it's going down Chadwick's throat, and he's looking a really strong runner at the back there. So they've got to try and get some territory, get some possession, and actually try and put Dr. Channelers under some pressure defensively, because at the moment it's all Dr. Channelers with the ball.
Well, we're not far away from half-time, as long as they don't concede again. Is that something that you'd be saying to them at half-time, it's just get some territory, build a few phases, and just try and find a way of getting into the game?
Yep. I think it's difficult because they've got to get their first phase defence right. They can't let this Dr. Chandler side through them, because then they're constantly defending around their 22. So they've got to get their first phase defence right. Then they may force some turnovers.
Not
well, 7 points to three right now. Dr. Chandler's looking to add just before the end of this first half. Into the 22 they come again.
Advantage offside.
Much of the territory has been here in the first half. Tunney is just too good. Beautiful try. James Tunney with the second try for Dr. Challoners. He's been very much their talisman in this first half. A beautifully worked second try from the school from Buckinghamshire. James Tunney is the scorer. 12-3 they lead.
He's a really strong ball carrier, but he's got some pace and footwork as well. He's not just a straight Bosch man, and with a sort of forward roll there at the end. Really athletic, exciting prospect, this young player. All of the good things that they're doing revolve around him. They've got a good spine, as we say. The scrum half's a really good player. The fly half's playing well. Chadwick at the back, he's counter-attacking brilliantly. So they've got key players in key positions here that are really hurting Sir Thomas Rich's defence.
So we're just approaching the end of this first half.
Thank you.
And Weatherall. Well, he hit that one like a 64-degree wedge, but it still went over. 14 points to three.
Yeah,
Dr. Chandler's lead.
That's a killer blow just before half-time, like the worst time to concede. They'd gone in 7-3, they'd have probably felt fairly confident, but 14-3 with the amount of possession that Dr. Chandler's have had and how potent that look out wide. So Thomas Richards have got to try and get their hands on the ball and actually force Dr. Challoners to defend.
So Dr. Challoners Grammar School from Amersham in Brockenhamshire leads to Thomas Richards School from Gloucester by 14 points to 3 at the end of the first half. So let's have a quick look at some of the action of this first half. This was the first try, Sam.
Yeah, Weatherall's done really well. A bit scrappy ball, but he's gone down there. He's looked after the ball well. Owens obviously heard the call that there's something on the left. Draw the man, give. Offload out the tackle. Draw the man, give. You're not stopping him from there. Really good stuff. Do the basics well. Run straight lines. Timing of the pass, all the things that kids are coached throughout the country at mini rugby and at schools, just do the basics, run straight, give a good pass, offload, great timing of the pass there, big man goes out in the corner.
Well, yes, and I think this may be the second try. Well, so this is still the first try from another angle, from behind the goal. It's a well worked try, it was.
And James really Tunney, good.
Yeah, absolutely.
They've obviously been working on their celebrations as well.
So both sides just having their team talks at half time. What will be the Sir Thomas Richards team talk, Sam?
They've got to get their hands on the ball, but they've got to play with some territory. And it's difficult at this age group because the kids can't kick the ball as far as they can when they're a little bit older. So I think they've got to try and keep it in hand. I think they've got to have a go. Dr. Challoners have got 3 men at the back ready for the kick, so it means they're only defending with 12. So I think they've got to try and work the overlaps and actually play with the ball in hand and give the game a go, because you don't want to come off this pitch at the end not having tried your best.
So let's look at the second try. This is James Tunney's second try.
Absolutely. Great play. Superb pass from Weatherall. Drew the man. And then he goes straight through the middle. Poor fullback there. Can't really do much. He thinks he's going to run over him. And then he steps. He's a really good player, the number 8. Most of the good things that are coming through their play is coming through Tunney. And Weatherall's bossing the show and really mixing up whether he uses his forwards or his backs really well.
14-3, the score at half-time. Let's see how they respond. That is the prize. Both sides are playing for the under-15s Vase. And let's see if Sir Thomas Richards, who was the Vase finalist here 4 years ago in 2012. Let's see if they can find a way back into this tie.
Ready.
14-3 down as Dan Walker gets us underway, and there's something a little bit different. Taking the low road instead of the high road. And so Dr. Challoners is starting as they left off.
Backwards!
A good tackle there, though, from Cameron Wilkinson to stop Richard Dean in his tracks. And that ball was blocked, so a good opportunity here was Thomas Richards. They got an early scrum, knock-on scrum to come. Knocking advantage, which they may take. They can't get anything from this. Here we go. Hocking into the 22. They aren't going to come back from that knock-on advantage.
No advantage.
Something for them to build on here.
Perfect attacking position. Middle of the pitch, you can attack either way. Really tough to defend. Thomas Richards want to get back into this game. This is a perfect example, perfect place for them to do that. And then it's game on if they get a score here.
Indeed. Scrum right on the centre of the 22. Picked up by Miles Wilson. Walker. Just shy of the line, because he kept it in play. He hasn't, you know. but ball has gone into touch. Good scramble defence from Dr. Challoners. With bodies galore there. But a good attacking intent though from Sir Thomas Riches.
Yeah, great play by both teams there. Really good attack, good offload.
Wait a minute.
Looked like
step
he was in.
Edge, please.
Kept the ball in play, but look at that scramble defence. Great defence on the line there.
It was indeed. A little bit of a scramble here as well, just on the 5 metre line. Dr. Chandler is looking
to
send this ball downfield. But the ball's been turned over.
Penalty advantage, red offside.
So what can Sir Thomas Riches do from this one?
Yeah, got that, thanks.
And with an advantage to come as well.
Number eight.
Penalty advantage to come. And they are going to come back for the penalty and
time off
here. And there could be a little bit of a talk here from our
same
referee,
sequence,
Andy Taylorson,
offside,
to eight, James Tunney.
Two offences, OK, repeat offences.
Was I offside?
You were offside twice. Give me that extra space. In this area, you've got to be careful. No, off you
two
go.
Repeat offences there for James Tunney, and tap and go is taken quickly.
Massive hit from Tunney. They've done well to keep the ball here, though.
They have done well indeed, and they still continue to try and drive forward with Liam Richards. They're scrambling, they're holding on for dear life here, Dr. Challoners.
Back foot.
Gordon. Trying to pick up, and it's Dr. Challoners who was really stopping them.
Move back.
Strong defence it is. Oliver Gordon, who's finding a little gap. And he may have been turned over, he has been. Tunney. Ball kick, but it's not going to go into touch. It's going to go down into Luke Pardo's throat. Pardo.
There's the ball.
Takes two men to get him down.
Move back. No,
Hocking.
Hands red.
Gordon trying to fish it out. He does so. Picked up by Eddington. Another
penalty
advantage to come. Another penalty. And now I think our referee is going to have a word with somebody here, and somebody's going to spend 10 minutes on the sidelines with lots of things. Yellow card it is indeed.
Side entry red.
I have to admit, I'm not a fan of yellow cards at this age group, especially when they're playing at Twickenham. But they have conceded three penalties on their try line, so I can maybe see where the ref's coming from. I think Sir Thomas Riches have got to play with a bit more width. Dr. Challoner's defence around the breakdown is really good. They've got some big players that they're soaking up that pressure. I think they've got to try and play with a little bit more adventure, move the ball and use the width of this massive pitch. And I think they'll get some dividends if they do that.
Sid Day spends 10 minutes in the bin. Coming on. Yazine Valjai has come on to the field.
Need to match up.
So what you'll see here now is actually in schoolboy rugby, it's often a hindrance if you get a sin bin to the opposition, because you have to have the same amount of numbers in the scrum. So you now don't have a number eight. So the ball will come flying out for the scrum half and you have no control.
Set.
Dom Goodman is the man who just come off the field as well for Valjai. And now, can it make this one-man advantage count?
Move it.
Gordon. They've got numbers on the right-hand side if they go quickly.
There's so much space out wide, you can't see it on your screens, but there's a huge overlap, there's masses of space. But they keep picking and going, maybe it'll pay dividends, but if they move the ball...
And another penalty.
Must release.
Another tap and go. Gordon.
Roll, Chatler!
Oh, popped up, and now the chance to clear, and into touch it goes, but back they come for another penalty. And it could be another talking to here.
Seven, captain, please. and 10, 7 and 10.
Again, though, it's still one out rugby. Someone's come on a crash ball. If they just played with a little bit more depth, move the ball through two phases, two sets of hands, I think that they can pose some a few more problems against this Dr. Challoner's defence that seem quite happy soaking up one out rugby or pick and go rugby.
No, it's both. Just follow them. The offside line is quite simple, it's the back foot.
So we'll go again. So Thomas Richards school on the front foot.
7 and 10 offside.
Tap and go again. Again, this is how short of the line they've been for much of this second half. Cut up metres short.
Move! 16, move!
Still to continue. To go forward and just shy of the line once more. Can they get it down? Can they get it down?
Let go, Red! Held up.
Ball's held up. One thing must be said, Sam, is Dr. Challoner's defence has been excellent.
It's absolutely fantastic, but they're not being tested. All they've got to do is just front up, basically, and smash people that are running straight at them. They're not having to defend the wide channels. They're not having to defend this huge, big pitch. Hopefully now, what a great scrum position to have an attacking scrum. 40 yards out on the blind side. Will they exploit it?
Quite simple, here's your mark. I don't expect you to go past.
So Gordon, scrum 5 metres out underneath the posts.
Bind, set.
Now they go right. It should be an opportunity here, should be an opportunity to try! And it is! I was about to say before that ball went in, there was plenty of room on the right-hand side. And as you mentioned, Sam, used the wings.
Yeah, superb execution. There's 50 metres of space, only two defenders, 5 yards from the line. Almost impossible to defend if you attack it. Draw the man, run straight. Lovely pop pass over for the try. Really, really good execution there. Again, attacking a little bit wider. I think that's where they've got to go.
Matthew Lampett, the try scorer. And loads of time as well in this game. We've got a 23 minutes and change.
Fully deserved score there. They've been on the line for the last, 10 minutes. They've kept the ball. They deserve that try. And as we said at half-time, if they can get some territory, then they're in this game. And that's exactly what they've done.
Got what they deserve there.
Thoroughly, thoroughly deserved.
Walker to reduce the deficit to 4. Great kick.
Another fantastic kick, really assured kicking from the fly half. So we really do have game on now. Towards the sort of last 10 minutes of the first half, it was looking ominous for Sir Thomas Richards, but this first 10 minutes, they've been absolutely fantastic.
14-10 as the sun shines here at Twickenham. Beautiful day, was for your forecast here, but a cold, chilling day here for me and Sam in the West Stand, I think we are.
See, they've got their men back there.
Anderson, Chadwick. Chadwick tries the offload, picked up by number 17, Ben Race on the field. To Richard Dean. At Bellamy on the field for Dr. Challoners.
Let go, Blue!
Wilkins, Tunney looking on a hat trick. Blake Morris puts his foot in touch.
Again, I'm not sure if you can see it on the screens, but Dr. Challoners have 3 men back whenever Sir Thomas Richards have got the ball, and they're just kicking it straight back down to their Chadwick, especially, who's running back really well. I'd like to see Sir Thomas Richards again use the ball, because they've got overlaps. They've got to trust their handling, trust their backs, because I think that they can actually be dangerous if they attack out wide. The It's very easy to say it from up here, though. And they're young kids. They're in the final at Twickenham. But I just think that if they can attack a little bit wider, they'll get more gains.
Time on Malcolm, please. No hands!
So Thomas Richards in possession.
Use it.
Gordon. Loose pass, and could be a little bit of danger here.
Backwards.
Picked up by Hunter, but he's been turned over. And this is Jake Wilkins. A sloppy pass has let in. Dr. Challoners here.
No hands, boy.
Ben Race.
Use it.
Bellamy. Weatherall. Tunney on a hat trick. Tunney using his strength. Underneath the post, 5 metres out. Dr. Challoners still a man down, just to remind you.
There's the ball.
But it may have been turned over. Ball uncontested. And there will be a red ball in the putting.
Time off, please, Malcolm. We've got some changes. Number one, please. Number one.
So just like a few minutes ago for Sir Thomas Richards, Dr. Challoners have got a fantastic position to have a scrum here. 40 yards on this blind side.
Back on the field. Sorry, Sam, carry on.
Wouldn't be surprised to see Tunney picking it up here and having a go for his hat trick.
Bind. Set. Yes.
Bellamy.
Not help. You lose the ball, leave it alone, please. Do you need treatment? Time off. It's a knock-on. Do you want some treatment?
Our referee, Andy Taylorson, just laying down the law.
Scrum down.
Scrum down for that knock-on, and it will be Sir Thomas Richards with a chance to clear their lines.
Yes. Go with him, scrum half, go with it. Use it!
Don't find touch, instead it finds the throat of Hubie Chadwick. Chadwick, using his pace to try and launch his counter-attack and gets into the 22.
No hands!
Bellamy.
Roll tackle!
And Griffiths. Bellamy. Weatherall. Weatherall collects and does well. Just shy of the 22.
No hands!
And they get the penalty. Tap and go taken by Bellamy, doesn't fancy the kick. Collingbourne.
Backwards!
Picked up by Sid Day.
Advantage, over!
Ball knocked forward and it's Thomas Richards sent downfield, and that is an excellent kick. Is it going to touch? It has!
Much better kick from Sir Thomas Richards, finding space, make the ball bounce. At the moment, previous kicks have been going straight down Chadwick's throat, who's gaining yards every single time.
Just brushes the touchline, does it? Yeah, ooh! I think, well, come to our touch judge, it did. One thing we'll just mention off mic there, Sam, is about the wind here. We're just seeing it is with helping Sir Thomas Richards in the second half.
Yeah, it's a fairly big wind, and so Thomas Richards are trying to use it. Another kick there.
It's going to be a bit of a hindrance for Dr. Chalmers in the second half. A bit of kicking tennis cut happening right now. Well, the tackle a little off the ball there on number 10, Daniel Walker, but always fair and legal. And that ball looked off forward and spotted by our referee, Andy Taylorson.
You Yeah, I think the ball didn't go into touch here, but the Chadwick, when he picks the ball up, his feet are out, which you see here. He picks it up now, which is why Sir Thomas Richards got the line out.
There you go.
So there you go.
Unfortunately, I think that another boy is coming off injured. I hate to see young lads coming off injured in these big games.
Spotting the, yeah, it's the fullback, number 15, Andrew Hunter, who's just got off the field. A little bit of leg trouble. Great crowd here this morning, here at Twickenham. Good drive forward, picked up by number 7, Joe Hocking. Gordon. Gordon finds a little bit of a gap, goes for a little dart and run himself.
Work harder, Red, work! Move!
And a nice little kick forward, that's just to put a little bit of pressure here for Chadwick. And it's going to be a good lineup for Sir Thomas Richards here, who really are on the front foot in this second half, Sam. It's
not going to work harder, yeah?
They're the ones who have been really applying the pressure.
Yeah, complete opposite of the first half. They've kept the ball. That's, again, another lovely chip. Putting the ball on the floor, not kicking it straight down the fullback's throat. And now they've got a line out 5 yards out.
Once again, a bit of a juggling act, and it might have gone the other way for them. Bellamy, kick downfield, and not a bad one too. It's going to put a little bit of pressure for Pardo. Chip forward, that one is, and again, a good kick.
Really clever kick from the young man there. Sees a little bit of space. The lottery is 50-50 because you can't lift anyway, so it doesn't really matter whose ball it is there. Again, pressure on Dr. Challoners, really close to their line.
19 blue, please. Okay.
Hunter coming back on the field after that little niggle. And now picked up by Sir Thomas Richards. Now then, what could they pick up here? 15 minutes to go. Continue to drive forward. So much of this, the start of the second half.
Back foot.
Again, pick up and drive. So many men on the right-hand side. So many men. We haven't seen it yet, though. And they continue to drive forward. And just short of the line, they are too. Three, four men on the right-hand side as they go now. Slow ball, though. And it's been lost. Ball's dropped, so it's going to be a knock-on. And it will be red putting. Sam, you're pointing out to me, there's so many lads on the right-hand side.
There's so much space out there, and they've got good runners out there, but they're just picking and going. They're getting that white line fever, which, again, is really tough in the heat of this big occasion to try and just have a calm head, maybe put two passes on the ball to attack a little bit of space rather than just trying to bulldoze over against this good Dr. Challoners defence.
Hold the pass!
Gordon. Gordon's spotted a little bit of space.
Great steal.
And a good steal it was from Dr. Challoners. And now they have a chance to launch the counter-attack here. They really are off of the races. What a run this is from Chadwick. Up to halfway.
No hands. Move.
Cross-field kick put Hunt under a bit of pressure, the bounce is awkward for him. But a lovely little step. And now been put into touch. Good rugby from both sides.
Yeah, fantastic counter-attack play from Dr. Challoners again. Chadwick on the ball, really dangerous runner, quick. He was looking to pass, but the pass wasn't on, so he kept the ball. And then Weatherall, using a lovely boot, put the pressure on Sir Thomas Richards.
Wilkins. Line out. But the ball was knocked forward, and it will be Dr. Chandler's with the putting. It's a Chadwick's run.
Yeah, he's got pace. If you just see, he's carrying the ball in two hands. He's aware of what's going on. No one near him. The pass isn't on. Goes down, gets the ball back, and the fly-off puts a great kick in.
11 and a half minutes or so to go.
Watch your mind.
Bellamy, Weatherall, Dean, Anderson, Morris. Kept in play. This is Anderson. Picked up by Richard Dean into the 22. One more score here from Dr. Challoners, who feel may be enough to see them over the line. Peters.
No hands, seven!
Weatherall. Dean. But the ball was knocked forward, and it's going to be a good attacking scrum here for Dr. Challoners, about 10 metres out in front of the posts.
Dr. Challoners' playbook for the backs is outstanding. They've run every single backs move you could possibly, and all of them have come off. Great skill set, and then just again there, there's probably been three offloads, really trying to keep the ball alive and put Sir Thomas Richards under pressure, and they're in a great position, as we said again here, right in front of the sticks, 50 metres either side to attack. This is going to be really hard to defend.
Straight out.
Bellamy. But the ball went a little bit too quick for our referee. Well, we found our man with the air horn. Detention for you in the morning, boy.
That's their moment of fame.
Mind.
Set.
Okay, in the middle.
Tunney on the hat-trick. Tunney, wonderful. Wonderful.
I was very surprised when they had the scrum there the last occasion, the nine passed it. Tunney almost impossible to stop from there with his pace and his power. He's been absolutely outstanding this game.
Superb play for the number eight, James Tunney, who has been stunning in this final. Three tries to his name.
Great fend there. Again, a little bit of footwork. He's not just running over people and using his size. He's actually running at shoulders. Okay, so if there is a tackle, he'd probably be able to offload anyway. Really good skill from this young man. Like, there's not a lot Weatherall can do there. He's bigger, he's quicker. If someone's quicker than you, there's not a lot you can do. He's a very impressive player, that young man.
Cue the celebrations. This to go 11 clear. Well, missed on the left-hand side on this occasion. 19 points to 10. Around 9 or so minutes. So Sir Thomas need to get on the board quickly. Anything will do right now. 3 points will give him an opportunity just to get on the board and maybe try and get a try in the last few minutes. They need to find something here in the next couple of phases of play. 9 points is doable.
Very much so. I say I would have thought they need some sort of points in the next couple of minutes to get themselves in this game.
Let go! Play on!
See, that kick from Weatherall, if he would have converted, would have given him a lot more breathing space. But Tunney, I think he's going to try and take this game with a scruff of the neck, really, and just... He has been a talisman for them today.
Plenty there or there? Late hit.
And the referee a late hit from our referee.
Number 8, you have to hit that, mate.
Go
that
quick.
Hit.
Go now. That's the look in. There we go. So they want to do. Oh, my word. Oh,
my advantage. Word.
Coach's nightmare.
Is that what I'm saying, Sam? You bang your head and think, just do the basics.
Yeah, you're screaming inside there. You need some points in the next couple of minutes. They don't have to go crazy. There's still enough time on the board. Just look after the ball. They've actually looked good in this second half when they've been in and around the 22. So they don't need to force that. Just hold on to the ball. Work the just normal passes will do. And that's all we're going to see it here.
Okay.
No need for that. He's not Sonny Bill.
7 minutes to go. Free kick. So now then, can they get something on the board here? And again, the passes are loose and scrappy. It's not what they're looking for. Still, they have possession though, to the school from Gloucestershire.
Release, Tattler!
Eddington just trying to go forward. And now then, it's an opportunity here. A little kick forward, a little dart towards the line. To put Ollie Anderson under pressure, and Anderson fancies a little run of his own. Anderson tries to beat one other man. Good inside pass. This could be the game here. Said Day inside to Daniel Peters. Peters to Weatherall. Ball still out there, picked up by Sid Day. But the ball was knocked forward, and so Thomas Riches need to get some points on the board from about 70 metres out.
What a fantastic counter-attack from Dr. Challoners. Okay, wingers are on up the right line. He's offloaded inside to the prop, who's again made a good pass. All Dr. Challoners are doing really is just the basics well. They're running at space, they're passing, the handling's excellent. And so Thomas Riches keep gifting them the ball by kicking it to them. When you're 9 points down, you've got to keep the ball in hand. Or if you do kick, you can't let them out there cheaply.
So this is Anderson's run getting past Oliver Gordon.
Set.
Sid Day. The inside pass to Peters and Weatherall, but the offload didn't work on that occasion. But Dr. Challoners now will look to advance with Blake Morris. Morris.
Use it!
Bellamy. Wilkins.
No hands, boom!
Chip forward there from Weatherall. But Hunter under pressure. And Hunter can only slice it out into touch. And Dr. Chandler's are in the right end of the field with 5 minutes to go.
See, that's outstanding play from Weatherall. It's completely different. They're 9 points up. Put the kick in behind and say, right, go and score from 90 yards. So really good play from Weatherall there. But again, it stemmed from Sir Thomas Riches kicking the ball to Dr. Chandler's, who can just mop up those kicks all day long.
Guy Floyd picks up.
No hands! Hold it there.
Charge down.
Release!
Joe Hocking. And now it looks like Sid Day has turned the ball over for Dr. Chandler's. Tunney looking for the quad here. Bellamy.
Back up. Use it!
Wilkins. This to put the coup de grace on the game, but it is a Thomas Riches penalty with 4 minutes to go. Sam, it's a bit of a, well, I want to say a rhetorical question, but I've got to ask you, who's your man in the match?
A few of those Dutch Challenge players have been outstanding. I think Weatherall at fly half has controlled the game brilliantly. Chadwick has counter-attacked fantastically whenever he's had the ball kicked to him, but it's tough to look beyond. The boy that scored 3 tries has looked outstanding whilst carrying the ball. Quick, powerful, great skills. So James Tunney is the man of the match this morning.
Absolutely, I couldn't agree with you more on that one.
Use it!
There's still time though, there's still 3.5 minutes left to play here, so Dr. Chandler's not over the line yet. Anderson, Colin Ball, kick downfield for Hunter under pressure, but Weatherall and Dean dump him in touch.
Great play by Weatherall. Again, another little 20-yard kick, made the ball bounce, then making the tackle and smashing them into touch. He's been outstanding. Again, really exciting prospect for the future. Really quality, good fly half. Good to see now the subs are all coming on. They're all going to get their couple of minutes that they can go back and say they've played at Twickenham.
Well,
great from the coach there, getting all these young boys on.
Indeed, it's confirmation.
11.
James Tunney gets our man of the match.
Seven, please. There you go. Well done. Time on.
A sterling performance from the Dr. Challoners, number eight. Something he can definitely tell the grandkids as I scored a hat-trick at Twickenham. And here comes the coup de grace, maybe. Anderson, no. Two and a half left to play.
I'm not sure if they're going to show a replay of this move, but I think Weatherall chucks in a little Carlos Spencer dummy pass to himself and then hits a wide pass. They're throwing all the back moves out there. Fantastic. Outrageous confidence. He's thrown one through the legs. He's now done a dummy pass to himself. I love to see that from a young man.
Just been relayed to the crowd, Sam's decision of the man of the match. And you've got to hear Sam, that about a few thousand people agreed with you.
Difficult to not agree with that choice.
Thank you.
Ball looped up into the air. Hunter. Back down the throat. Time now, the enemy force.
Keep
Thomas Richards
right.
School.
Don't move. Okay.
And the needed. Well, maybe.
No hands around!
I'm going to prayer here.
Use it.
If they're going to be taking on this Vase, and with 90 seconds on the clock and a stern Dr. Chandler's defence, then the odds are most definitely against them.
Dr. Challoners' defence has been absolutely outstanding. Like, their attacking play has been great, but they've shown resilience on their line. They've counter-attacked really well. It's not just an attack that they've great. They've got the four-round game, and you can see, you can understand why their results leading up to this final have been so impressive. They're a really good side.
Just wait, please.
This cool and easterly breeze comes across the ground here. Let's look it up.
Come on.
Myself and Sam,
come on, let's go.
Wrapped up for the Arctic weather up here in the stand.
It's freezing up here.
But as I said at the start of the show, it's a furnace of action here at Twickenham today. That keeps us warm.
It has been a cracking game. Really great way to start the day on these four finals. Brilliant start.
Anderson.
Keep coming, Red! Keep coming!
Picked up Wilkinson. Good tackle there by Sid Day.
He's been everywhere today. Been really impressed by Sid Day. He's been all over the park. He's got good skills, handling, passing. Really impressive from that prep.
The tackle. Counting down the time here, the crowd. They're counting down the clock on the screen. We're at zero. We're at zero on our time in the red as well. Oh my word!
Wow!
Well, my word. I think I'm pretty sure Elvis had bigger hits than that. My word.
Thank you.
Fantastic. Now, can Thomas Richards get something on the board? and that may be a consolation try here at the end.
Careful! Scrum advantage.
So scrum to come, not an advantage, but I think they're going to carry ploughing on here. A little bit of an opportunity blowing, a little bit high that look there, but we continue. And still picked up by Dan Walker. That looks a little bit high as well.
Release Shuttle!
Gordon. This is Zaire Rafai. And that ball's gone into touch, and that is surely the game. It certainly is. Congratulations, Dr. Challoners Grammar School of Amersham in Buckinghamshire. They have won the 2016 Vase for under-15s.
Yeah, thoroughly deserved, Dr. Challoners. They played really, really well. When they had their chances, they took them. And that was probably just the difference. So Thomas Riches had a few chances in that second half. They got turned over on the try line. Chadwick counter-attacked, and then they didn't really look like scoring again after that.
Congratulations.
I would say tale of two halves. You know, the first half, Dr. Chandler's really found two tries. In the second half, Sir Thomas Riches got back into the score, and there's a couple of times you were shouting up here, got under your breath, go wide, go wide, go wide. They created the opportunity, they just couldn't get over the line.
Yeah, the one time they put some width on it, they scored. They were in the same position about 5 minutes later. They tried to pick and go, and as I said, unfortunately, just coughed up the ball. And after that, they didn't really look like scoring again in the game. But as I said earlier, cracking opening first game, and what, we've got three more like that to come, hopefully.
Indeed, absolutely. The under 15 Vase final has been won by Dr. Challoners School. Dr. Challoners Grammar School of Amersham in Buckinghamshire. Their motto of the school, to the stars through difficulty. I think that's quite apt.
I'm not sure what to make of that motto, but yeah, they've actually reached the star today. They were excellent and real good performances from what, as we said, the spine of the team. Wilkins at Hooker had a real good game. Tunney, we've obviously talked about, outstanding. Weatherall controlled the game at 10. The centres of Dean and Connaball were always a threat. And as I said, Chadwick at the back counter-attacked superbly. So real spine of the team played well. And that's what you want in these big games in the finals. You want your core players, the spine, to play well. And if they do, you'll generally be okay.
The doctor was most definitely in the house. Dr. Chandler's school has won by 19 points to 10. They have taken the under-15s Vase. So both sets of teams now making their way up the stairs here at Twickenham. Receiving their runners-up medals right below us. Still cheered on by the fellow pupils from both sides. So now, Dr. Challoners Grammar School on their way up the stairs here to Twickenham. First time here at Twickenham, the first final. their first final. And they collect the Vase. Since the year 2000, there's always been a different winner of this competition, the under-15s Vase. A great repressage tournament for teams that go out the cup early to give them a chance to come to Twickenham. And we've been richly rewarded here. And credit must go to the Dr. Challoners, faithful as well, that the all below me here, I'm counting a good, I would say a good 800 to 1,000 that must have come. So the crowds begin to stream in for the next game as well, which is our under-15s cup final, which is due to kick off in about 15 minutes from now. But it's Ed Griffiths who'll be the last man to collect the Vase. Collects the Vase from, and they are confirmed champions of the under-15s Vase for 2016. So there we have it. One down, three to go here at Twickenham. Dr. Challoners Grammar School have won the under-15s Vase. One of their former alumni was the actor Roger Moore. Dr. Challoners are definitely some in double O heaven.
Yeah, they absolutely. It's probably the best moment that they actually experience when they're up there, they're lifting the trophy, you're with your mates, they're all going nuts. Thoroughly deserved. Well done then. They're going to have a great day. What's great to see, Sir Thomas Rich's, all their players down there, not disappearing, making sure that they cheer on Dr. Challoners. It's great to see the spirit within rugby still going down there with those boys. But yeah, fair play, Dr. Challoners. They were really impressive, and hope that they can now, day's done for them, they can enjoy this day whilst all the other schools are waiting for their games to come.
Absolutely. Dr. Challoners Grammar School, under-15s Vase champions, beating Sir Thomas Rich's school by 19 points to 10.